Graphicara University, Dehradun, School of Pharmacy, present this session for medicinal chemistry. Today, we will continue with general anesthetics, part 2, under the drug acting on central nervous system. I am Associate Professor Dr. Ahmed Nawaz Khan from School of Pharmacy. So, what are these general anesthetics? These general anesthetics are the medicine that render a patient reversibly unconscious and unresponsive in order to allow surgeon to operate on that patient. That means these anesthetic agents, they are essential for some surgical procedures where it may be safer or more comfortable for the patient to be unconscious. And it is usually used for long operations or those that would otherwise be very painful. These general anesthetics are normally administered intravenously or by inhalation by a specialist doctor, which is called anesthetist, and who also monitor the patient's vital sign, including breathing, heart rate, blood pressure, and temperature during the operation procedure. It is not clear exactly how it works, but it's known that all the anesthetics, they interrupt the passage of signal along the nerves in the brain. And this means that any stimulation to the body does not get processed or recognized by the brain. That is why under the general anesthesia, a patient is unable to feel the pain and will likely wake with some short-term amnesia, that means memory loss. And that's why the patient do not feel any pain. So before having an operation, whenever a specialist doctor, which is an anesthetist, when he comes, he asks the medical history of the patient, whether the patient or anyone from the family has or had the problem with anesthesia or not. So then only the anesthetist give the anesthesia to the patient. These anesthetic drugs, they are the agent that produce a complete or partial loss of feeling. And these are of three kinds. There are general anesthetics, these are regional anesthetics, and they are local anesthetics. So when a patient undergoes a general anesthetics, they lose the sensation and become unconscious. But that is reversible, loss of sensation and unconsciousness. Now there are some stages of the general anesthesia. So just like when an inhalation anesthetic is administered to a patient, there are some stages which are produced by increasing the blood concentration of that agent, and the anesthesia is produced. Now what are those stages? There are four stages. The first stage is stage of analgesia, second stage of delirium, then stage of surgical anesthesia, stage of surgical anesthesia, stage of medullary depression. So now what are these stages? Now let's discuss them one by one. So this stage of analgesia, this is the period from the beginning of anesthetic administration of the drug to lose the consciousness, and patient progressively loses the pain, and this stage is also called as stage of analgesia because there is a loss of pain. This is related to analgesics. The second is stage of delirium, and this period or this stage extends from the loss of consciousness through a stage of irregular and specific breathing to the re-establishment of regular breathing. And respiration is normal and regular. The patient may laugh, vomit, or even if he can struggle, and for this reason, it is called the also known as stage of excitement. Now, then it comes to the stage 3, which is stage of surgical anesthesia. In this stage, excitement is lost. In the delirium, it was there. In the excitement was there. The patient can laugh, the patient can vomit. But here in the third stage, the patient excitement is lost and skeletal muscles get relaxed. And most type of the surgeries are done in this stage. When a patient achieved or reached this stage, stage of surgical anesthesia, then the surgeries are started. Now the last stage, fourth stage, is stage of medullary depression. And when this stage occurs, the overdose of the anesthetic may bring the patient to this stage. And the respiratory and circulatory failure occurs at this stage. And this is very harmful stage. So, and this is because of the overdose of the anesthetic. That's why anesthetists, they always calculate or they pre-calculated the drugs or agent which are used for the surgery. And the dose is not same for all the patients. It depends person to person. Now, what are the types of or the general classification of the anesthetics? These anesthetics, they are classified according to their nature, that is volatile or non-volatile at room temperature. So volatile inhalation, general anesthetic, they are administered by the inhalation and are further divided, subdivided into gas and liquid, just like gas into cyclopropane, ethyl chloride, nitrous oxide, liquid diethyl ether, halothane, chloroform, etc. Non-volatile or intravenous anesthetics given to the veins, they are non-volatile at room temperature and are administered by the intravenous route. Just like barbiturates and non-barbiturates, we have covered these barbiturates and non-barbiturates in the sedative and hypnotics, like thiopental sodium, methohexital sodium, and propofol, etc. Now, other classifications is also there, just like based on the mode of administration, like inhalation anesthetics, those who are inhaled, ultra short acting barbiturates like barbiturates and non-barbiturates, and dissociative anesthetics. These dissociative anesthetics are the class of the anesthesia which are basically characterized by the catalepsy and catatonia, analgesia, amnesia. Amnesia is the memory loss, and catalepsy, which is characterized by seizures and with the loss of sensation and consciousness, and catatonia. Catatonia is a state of basically immobility. That means which is the movement and behavioral abnormality which is arising from the disturbed mental state. So this dissociative anesthetic is a class of anesthetic agent which is related to the catalepsy, catatonia, analgesia, amnesia. Now, the mechanism of anesthetics. However, it is not well known that what is the mechanism of anesthetics. But in general, these general anesthetics, they inhibit the central nervous system neuronal activity. But their precise mechanism of neuronal inhibition is although not clear. So, several mechanisms are proposed of these general anesthesia or anesthetics. And the first is the lipid theory. And according to this theory, the more lipid soluble general anesthetics concentrate in hydrophobic region of neuronal cell membrane and cause the swelling of these membranes. So due to this hydrophobic nature, due to this swelling of the structure membrane, which is because of this hydrophobic region, they block the sodium channels. And when they block the sodium channel, they generate the action potential and which cause the inhibition and produce the anesthesia. That means they do not, or the patient do not feel any pain because of blocking of the sodium channels. The second theory is the protein theory. And after this lipid theory, the Mayer and Overton theory came, and which correlated the potency of these general anesthetics with their lipid solubility. And what that theory was said, Mayer and Overton, that the higher value of partition coefficient of the compound, more will be its general anesthetic property. It is not general for other category of drugs, but I'm talking about the anesthetics. So the higher the value of the partition coefficient of anesthetic compounds, more will be its general anesthetic property, potencies. Next was the protein theory. It was very general that anesthetics bind to the hydrophobic site of protein molecule of the neuronal cell membrane. Thus, the membrane function is altered and produce the anesthesia. Now, what are the characteristics of anesthetics? So, when we use the anesthetics or anesthetist, calculate the dose as well as the property of all these anesthetic agents which are going to be used for the patient during surgery. So, he always take care of the certain characteristic of anesthetics that it should be potent and non-inflammable. It should be non-irritating to the mucous membrane and it should produce rapid and smooth anesthesia. And it produces analgesia as well and muscle relaxation in addition to the anesthesia. And it should not produce any hypotension, should not produce any nausea and vomiting, and it should be compatible with all other drugs, adjuvant drugs, which are used in the anesthesia. And finally, it should be stable to heat, light, and alkali. So this is about the general mechanism of the general anesthetics and characteristic of general anesthetics. Next class, we will discuss one by one the compounds which are used as an anesthetics and some synthesis.